Good afternoon, students. So let us discuss a very important topic, group discussion today. So generally, what is called a group discussion, students? So why a group discussion is very, very important? So there are so many advantages about learning the etiquettes of group discussion. So let us take, so when we reach the third year, so we would be, going through the campus placements and all. So there is so much of importance to know the etiquettes of GD. So what is a GD actually? A group discussion is a thing where a group of people sit together, discuss on a topic and come out with a solution. So there are different kinds of GD, like formal GDs and informal GDs. So especially we'll be talking about the formal GDs that would be conducted in colleges. So that would be conducted in office and all. So where we discuss on a particular problem and come out with a solution. So the purpose of a GD is nothing but to have different perceptions on a problem and to clear the problem. So let us go deep into the topic. So there are different types of group discussion, dear students. Like, let me introduce you topic-based or knowledge-based topic. What is this topic-based and knowledge-based topic? So it's nothing but the general awareness topic, so that the students should be aware of. Like, for example, child labor, demonetization, Swachh Bharat, so women empowerment. So all these topics gives us the general knowledge. Dear students, the first priority of conducting group discussion would be this one. Like, you know, because students, it is the responsibility of the students to be aware of the general issues what are going on in and around the society. Students, let me tell you that we can update our knowledge by reading through newspapers, journals, magazines and all, and that we can gain enough knowledge to participate in this group discussion. What is the second type? This is called controversial or argumentative topic. Students, this is very critical topic where, you know, even HR things to give you in the placement lines also. So why this is very, very important? So let me give you some of the examples of controversial topics. So like, women are better managers than men, and, you know, co-education, or let me even say that, reservation systems and all. So generally when these kinds of topics are given students, so they generally take it personally. So students, let me tell you, when you take any topic personally, definitely you lose your control. You feel emotional and you lose your control. When you lose your control, dear students, you speak whatever you get, and that would, you know, make it into a debate. So, and we will be, you know, coming out of a discussion. Let me tell you, dear students, so group discussion is a different topic from a debate. So debate is different and group discussion is different, dear students. Let me tell you that in a group discussion, we sit together collectively and try to solve a problem. But debate is not like that, students. So in a group discussion, we'll be having cooperation, coordination, helping one another and trying to solve the problem. So, but if you make a GD, a controversial topic or an argumentative topic into a debate, so then we will get no solution, dear students. So we should keep it in mind, you know, while we are participating in a controversial or argumentative type of group discussion. And let me tell you, the another important topic or type is called abstract topic. Dear students, abstract topics are very, very important. And let me tell you, they are very, very difficult to answer, dear students, because we don't use any material to answer that kind of topic. So we just generally use our, you know, all the five senses, and if you think on the topic, dear students, will get definitely an answer, and we can relate it to reality and we can speak. Let me tell you some of the examples of abstract topics. Like, you know, every cloud has a silver lining. And let me tell you, A is an alphabet, or a teardrop on my guitar, or green is better than red. So, for example, when the topic is green is better than red, so what we just sense? So when we see that, we see the different colors, so the clue words that will be there in the topic, like the red and green, so these colors, what they represent in our day-to-day life. So let us say where green, where in what places we see this color green. So generally we see in the greenery, the environment, and one of the colors of a national flag is green, and the hospital color is green. So all these things we can spell out, dear students. And now what is red? So red is something, it symbolizes danger, and one of the colors of the traffic light is danger. So red is danger, so it implies danger. So we'll say that, and finally we say like why green is better and why red is danger. So we can say that, so green is like, green is for granary, green is for prosper, green is for heritage, so it is for prosperity. We can say like that, and we can simply prove that, so how green is better than what symbolizes red and all. So how these colors, so green is better than red. In this way we can say, dear students, we can answer the topic. And so let us move ahead into the another topic, like what are the skulls that are caused while we are participating in a group discussion. Students, this is very, very important. Basing on the topic, we need to exhibit some of the talents that are demanded on a particular topic. So let us talk about the topic based or the knowledge based topic. So because the topic is knowledge based or topic based, dear students, it is direly needed that you need to have in-depth knowledge on the subject. So that means whenever a general awareness topic is there, our duty is to get so much of information and to give the information. So definitely the skills that would be gauged would be like in-depth knowledge on the subject. And what would be gauged in the next? So ultimately and definitely communication skills would be gauged. So what is that we communicate? So like communication skills involves, dear students, the content words what we use on the topic. And not only that, dear students, clarity of thought, clarity of voice is also primarily demanded. So let me tell about the presentation skills. What you know is not only important, dear students, but how you present is also important. And let us take this controversial topic. So when you go ahead with the controversial topic, dear students, you should control your emotions. So you should balance your emotions. As I already said that, so students will take those topics personally and they get connected to it and they will feel emotional. So never take any GD topic personally and don't feel emotional and don't lose your balance. So and the next important trait that are lost is nothing but negotiation skills. How well you negotiate things at all. And the most important trait that is evaluated will be conflict management skills. So without knowing the etiquettes of GD, dear students, so students will come up and they start making a group discussion into a debate. So then conflict management skills should be there where we mediate the situation. So and next, so stress management skills also are also very, very important. When somebody is always giving you counter up counter, so how you control your emotion and how you balance things and how you respond is also very, very important. So now let us come back to abstract topic. Dear students, when you are talking or when you are participating in an abstract topic, as I already said that we do not have much material to speak on it and we need to think individually and we need to present. So in that case, what skills are lost? So let me tell you spontaneity. What is spontaneity? Responding to the context all of a sudden, thinking it very fast and trying to respond is very, very important. Let me tell you, dear students, when the building is on fire, what you do? So either you WhatsApp and upload in your status that the building is on fire, or you call 100, or you use the fire extinguishers, it's all up to you, like how spontaneous you are. So now, next the thing, the skills that are caused is creativity, dear students. Creativity is nothing but, you know, thinking out of the box. See, like how you are applying things to reality and how you are reflecting, how you are responding is very, very important, dear students. And at the same time, I already said that every topic is a problem and we need to sit together and solve the problem. And the next thing is analyzing skills. How well you understand the problem
and how well you take decisions and think in an effective way to solve the situation, that is called analyzing skills, dear students. Apart from all these skills, there are many more skills that will be gauged, you know, by conducting group discussion. So, dear students, how to start a group discussion? As we have learned, like, what are the different types of group discussion and what are the skills that are evaluated in a group discussion, even we should know how to start a group discussion. So, starting is very, very important, dear students, because the starters of a group discussion or the person who initiates a group discussion is the steerer of the group discussion. So, now, how will we start a group discussion? Like, we can start with an introduction, we can start with a definition, we can start with a quote, we can start with a proverb, we can start with a quotation, we can start with an anecdote, we can start with a question, but that should be followed by your answer, dear student. So why we start with all these things? So nothing serious, dear student, but in order to make a presentation effectively, so we'll be using all those things like shocking statements, you know, statements which will be provided in newspapers and all, facts and figures. So all these things will make our presentation excellent, dear students. And not only that, the person who starts the group discussion would be identified by everyone in the group. So that's why, dear students, you should start it very, very effectively. So, and let me tell you, dear students, there are some techniques that are to be applied while you are participating in a group discussion. So, let us take one topic like, is Swachh Bharat a success or a failure? So, if the topic is this, so we need to think like, what are the keywords? The keywords like, is Swachh Bharat a success or a failure? So now, students, how do we start it? So obviously, as I have explained it earlier, we would be starting with a quotation or a proverb or a statement or something like I just would like to say like cleanliness is next to godliness. Like we can even say what's the meaning or definition or introduction of Swachh Bharat, like, you know, Swachh Bharat is nothing but to keep our surroundings clean and green. So and next we can start like who started, where started, why started, when started. So this will give us a brief introduction like about the history of a Swachh Bharat. So then students, next what? So while we are presenting, as I said, dear students, we need to use presentation skills. So next we can divide the topic into different segments and we can apply the techniques what I have written here, dear students. So let us use this spelt technique. What is this spelt technique? So let me introduce you. So what S stands for? S stands for society, standards, status, and P stands for politics, politicians, policies. E stands for economy, budget, economical. And L stands for law, legalities, rules. And T stands for technical, technology, and techniques. So how do we apply the spell technique when we use this group discussion? As we already started, dear students, about the introduction and also about, we also have given the, you know, what it is, a proverb of this, a quotation about this Swachh Bharat, that cleanliness is next to godliness. And we have even given the shorts like, so the definition of Swachh Bharat, and we have even told the history like who started, where started, why started, when started, with what time it started. So then next we can speak about the standards of the society, the standards of the society, and how, you know, the society is. So how the policies are in the society. So like we can say that how and what people are doing with Swachh Bharat. Like, you know, so is the society following the standards of the society, of Swachh Bharat. So how well is the society participating in Swachh Bharat? So dear students, we can say that people are not at all following Swachh Bharat. And what they are doing, what's the status of the people? So they are collecting rubbish and throwing the garbage on the streets. So this is what the society is doing. Suddenly, why people are throwing rubbish on the streets? Why people are throwing? Can we come out? Like, what are the problems? What makes them to throw the rubbish or the garbage on the streets? So let me tell you, dear students, there are so many problems why people throw rubbish on the roads. Like, for example, let me tell you, like, people are not aware. So they are not aware of the problems that would be created if you throw the garbage on the roads. So what will happen if you throw? So maybe it may prone to the traffic problems, or you know, blockages, the drainage blockages, and the mosquitoes brood over, and that will lead to dangerous diseases like you know, typhoid, malaria, and other so many diseases. And then what? So traffic problems and all. So why people are throwing? As I said, so one is because of lack of awareness, and next is because, you know, people or government is may charge money for the rubbish. So who will pay money for the dust? So because of all these problems, so people are throwing, or the status of the society is like they are throwing rubbish on the streets. So now what are the possible solutions, dear students? So people should be aware of the problems that would be created when you throw garbage on the streets. So how do we, you know, create awareness among them? So we can create awareness among them by so many awareness programs. So advertisements, signboards, notice boards. So in this way, they will be aware, short films and all. So they will be aware of the problems that would be created when, you know, they throw rubbish or garbage on the streets. So now the problem is solved. So what we have done? We have told like what the society or the standards or the status of the society. What makes them not to follow the Swachh Bharat properly? So we have identified the problems, and we have identified the solutions also. Like government should not collect money for the rubbish, and what government should provide awareness programs so that people may not throw the rubbish outside. Okay. What still we can apply? So next thing we can apply about politics, politicians and policies. So what is this politics? What is this politicians? And what are the policies? So it's nothing but, dear students, you know, the involvement of politicians in Swachh Bharat. So we see that many more politicians would be involved in Swachh Bharat campaigns and all. So what will happen? So what are the problems that would be created when they are involved in these programs? So students, definitely, like, you know, so the budget what is categorized to that particular area would be going directly into the pocket of that politician. So he will waste that money for his publicity, for his photographs, for the banners, for his security and all. So what makes when this happens? So definitely, dear students, much of the budget,